Okay, in the next case, pressure exerted by the liquids and gases. Okay, in the previous case, we have seen pressure exerted by the solid, right? So now we have to understand that liquid also can exert force as well, and even gas also can exert force. We are going to see that. Okay, so before going to see the topic, look at these four diagrams. Okay, I'm going to ask the question. Look at these four diagrams. So initially, understand this. Okay, so here same size tube they have taken, and they pour water, and the bottom they have take balloon sheet like okay or thin rubber sheet. Okay, they have to tie with that gum or any wrappers or any thread. Okay, whatever. So they have to pour water from here. So the level of the water should be here. And again they have to pour the water. Now the level of the water will be this much. That means there is some variation in the height. So due to the variation in the height, what will happen in the bottom? So the bottom gets somewhat bulky, right? It will be enlarged. Same way, just look at this here. So I have taken one bottle, and at the bottom I have to put one hole. So in that I have to insert one tube, and through that I have connected with the balloon sheet or any thick rubber sheet. So if I pour the water, what will happen to this balloon? You will say the answer. Okay, and this last one, I have to put equal size hole in that equally, that's around that edge. Okay, same height. So if I pour the water, how it will be coming? Okay, so this is one figure. This activity I gave in the animation, so you can understand in the better manner. Okay.
Pressure is exerted by gases.
Okay, the pressure exerted by the liquid. Okay, so this is that activity. So how the pressure can be exerted? So initially, I have taken one small tube and this one the rubber sheet, and I pour the water. Okay. So what will happen once it will be going there, means so the size of that balloon sheet, it will be increasing based on that water level. If I am increasing further and further and further, the size also increasing, right? So the next case, I have taken one empty jar. So through that I am going to make one hole. So through that incense stick I have put one hole. Okay, so here in that equal I have to insert one tube, and I connected with the balloon sheet. If I going to pour the water, what will happen? So once the water reached this tube, it will transfer and here. So what happened to this one? So the size of that balloon will be somewhat increasing. Okay. So what will happen? So that time. So these are the activity, right? And see here. So what will happen? Can you say the answer? Okay. The next one, I have taken the empty jar, and I am going to put water. Okay, so through that I put hole here. So what will happen? So here one size, here same size, means pressure gets equally. But if I increase that, here means the water reaching position will be very less. That means if you are going to the bottom, the pressure will be very high. Okay, can you understand? Okay. See here. So from this activity, what you can understand, actually the liquid will exert the pressure in the all side of the container. Okay, and particularly if you are pour the water at the bottom edge, it will be very high pressure, so that only the sea divers, okay, while they are going to the bottom of the sea or deep of the sea, means they have to use some special equipments. Why? Because of high amount of, enormous amount of pressure while you are going deeper into the water, so that only they have to wear some special kind of instruments. So whenever you are going to that deeper, some more height towards, that means the pressure will be very high. Okay. The next case. Okay. So what is the, in this activity, what you can understand? Okay. So based on the height, the liquid level also can be changed, right? Transporting the liquid level also can be changed, and liquid exert a sideways pressure. That means in that container it will exert the pressure also. Okay, So liquid exert equal pressure at the same height. If it is in the third acuity, what we have seen, we have to take one jar and we have to put the hole in the same equal size. That means same amount of water will come. It will reach the same distance also. Can you understand? So height and what is called height, based on the height, how the pressure will be varying, that we have seen. See here, the pressure exerted by gas. So for this, I gave an activity, how the pressure exerted by the gas. Okay.
Pressure exerted by gases. Like liquids, gases also exert pressure. Let us see some examples to understand this. As you inflate a balloon by pumping in the air, the air makes the balloon expand by exerting pressure on the walls of the balloon. Now if you open the mouth of an inflated balloon,
what will happen?
Yes. You feel
it will go.
It is coming out of the balloon very fast. It is because the air comes out with pressure. If you try to inflate a balloon having holes, are you able to do so? No. It is because air exerts pressure on the walls of the balloon and leaks out of the holes, and hence the balloon does not get inflated. So we conclude that air also exerts pressure. Now we know that the earth is covered with the envelope of gases known as atmosphere. And now we also know that air or gases can exert pressure. The pressure exerted by the air present in the atmosphere is called atmospheric pressure. Let us see what is the magnitude of this air pressure, or how small or big is it. Take a good quality rubber sucker. Press it hard on the floor such that it sticks. Now try to pull it off the surface. What do you observe? It is very hard to pull it off. Why is it so? It is so because as the sucker is pressed hard against the floor, most of the air between the sucker and the floor escapes out. Now atmospheric pressure outside the sucker makes it stick to the floor, and to pull it off, force equal to the atmospheric pressure is required. With this activity, we get a rough idea about how large is the value of atmospheric pressure. From these activities, we have learned about the pressure.
Okay, so in this activity, what you understood? First, I'll explain. So if you take one balloon and blow it, okay, so after a certain time, what will happen? The balloon will get burst out. Why? Because inside that balloon, if you are giving air through your mouth, means, so it will giving that force, or it will give the pressure in random direction, okay. So all the direction the pressure gets move, okay, so that even in the wall of the balloon, that means in the sheet of the balloon, the lot of amount of pressure will be there, right? So when we are comparing the outside of the balloon, it will be less pressure. So what will happen to inside of the balloon? So as you know, one fact you have to know, so the high pressure always go to occupy and the low pressure side, okay? So inside the balloon, high pressure will be there, outside the balloon, low pressure will be there. So that high pressurized gas will try to escape out from the balloon, so that only still if you are giving that force, so what will happen? So the balloon pressure will be very high, at one stage it will be burst out, so it will go and occupy that the low pressure area, okay. And in the second case, that means what we have taken means, see here, in the second case I'll explain. So here, even in that while you are swimming, this kind of balloon you have taken, right? So why it is means because of to reduce that pressure, okay. And here in that tire, see, look at the tire, okay. So this also, so once if you are exerting that, if you are giving that gas to the tire, means, so the gas will go in there, all the sides of the tire, it will exert the pressure on the wall, okay, so that only the tire will be somewhat pressurized tire, so we can go smoothly, right? Okay, so this is the balloon, that example I said. So if you give a lot of pressure, means, so that it will be exerting the pressure in that random direction, so the balloon will get burst out once if you are giving the lot of amount of force. See here, and this also, In the swimming pool, we are all using this kind of balloon, no, right? And here we have to attach it with our body, right? So that means it will give less pressure, so we can float it easily in the water. Okay, what is meant by atmospheric pressure? See, you know one thing, in the earth, it consists of what's called nitrogen, oxygen, everything. This is a composition of air, right? So air is composed in the earth. So I already said, even the air also can exert a pressure. That means, sir, why, sir, we cannot feel that pressure means? Because air molecules and all, the distance between that air molecules will be very high, right? So that only we cannot feel that much pressure. So even due to the presence of air in the atmosphere, it can create the pressure. That is called atmospheric pressure. Due to the atmospheric gases, it can create the pressure. So that only they said that activity, right? One thin balloon, what's called rubber sheet, they have taken and they have to press it hard. And after a certain time, if you pull with a less amount of force, means you cannot take. Because once if you are pressing that sheet, so inside the gases, all the gases will come out. So what happened? So only the atmospheric pressure will be present. Okay. See here. So what is the atmospheric pressure? So atmospheric pressure is nothing but due to the air around us, it can be create the pressure. Okay. So here they have to taken one wall, 10 cm, 10 cm, that box they have to taken. So in that 10 centimeter box, if you have seen the, with a naked eye, that means we said there is nothing is there, sir. No, it is there. That means due to the gas, it exert pressure on the wall. Okay. So these things are related to the atmospheric pressure. Okay. So due to that weight of the air also having weight. Okay. Okay. See, look at this activity. These two activity, okay. So here also some horses are there, also some horses. I think in your book also they gave it, at the last page they gave. So they have used one thick rubber sheet, okay. So what they do, so here also the horse is pulling, here also the horse is pulling, means in which direction the pressure will be get more. So the pressure will be equally exerted at the center, right? So at one stage what will happen? So that it cannot pull it out. Why? Because they have to apply the equal amount of force, right? So if any of the force will be very greater, means that sheet will be, it will break. Okay, so this is the balloon, that's a rubber sheet, thick rubber sheet. Okay students, so this is the today's topic. I hope you understand. So again I will revise that. Okay, what is that pressure? Pressure is nothing but perpendicular force act in the particular area. Okay, so pressure unit is called Newton per meter square. Okay, so and one more unit is there, that's called Pascal. PA they said Pascal. So Pascal is nothing but the scientist name. Okay, French scientist, it's called Blaise Pascal. So pressure can be measured in the way of 1 Pascal, 2 Pascal, that kind of also they can say. And not only pressure exerted in the solid, so it can exerted in the liquid and gases also. For that I put one activity also. Okay, so even the small amount of air also can exert that pressure. Okay, and any activity, if you see a lot of things, even in the railway station and all, the railway workers, okay, they have to use that one carpet, right? This kind of carpet they have to use. That carpet area should be very broad. Why they have to use that broad size? Means to reduce the weight, because to reduce the pressure, that means we are increasing the area. Even in the village and all, that women and all carrying water, right? So with the vessel, so once what they are using, they have to use one type of cloth, right? The cotton cloth they have to use, and they have to increase the size. They have to wind the cloth and they have to increase the area of that cloth. That means they feel some amount of less weight. So it will be very, very useful in the day-to-day life applications. So most of the time you can see any activity if you have taken, so whenever the larger area will be present, so the less amount of pressure will be there. Larger area, less pressure. Okay, and even in the while you are holding the pen, that also it will be very less area only. The contact area of contact will be very less, so that only you can give more pressure to the pen, so that only you can write it better manner. Okay, so these are the activities, these are the topics. So thank you all. I hope you understand. We will meet again. Thank you. Okay.